Hi, I'm James Catherall, co-founder of Catherall Audio, and today we're talking about backup plans in case of main stage failures featuring this device. Let's get to it. This is the Play Audio 12. It's an audio interface with a unique feature. It's got an automatic failover that can switch between two different computers if it detects that one of them is crashed. Sounds like magic, but it's actually pretty simple. Let's start by walking through the setup. It's got two USB Type B ports on the front so you can connect your two different computers, plus a USB Type A port so you can connect a USB hub or a MIDI controller. I'm going to be using this MIDI controller for this video. The MIDI controller can send messages to both computers simultaneously. That way, during the performance, both concerts will be in the same place. You can change patches right now so you can see. Now, to set up the automatic failover, you need to go to the concert level in main stage and add a new channel strip. Then you'll go to the utility section and add a tone generator and change that channel strip to output 13. Output 13 is a special virtual output inside of the machine that listens to that sine wave, and if it detects any dropouts or any other type of weirdness, it'll automatically switch to the other computer without you even noticing so that things can continue moving flawlessly. You can tell you have it set up right if you see the flashing green light on the front of the device. This tells you that the automatic failover is armed and it's ready to go. If it starts flashing red, that tells you that it's switched over to computer B. This can happen automatically, or you can do it manually, just by touching the front of the device. This is actually a touch display. Or you can plug in a pedal if you have an AB pedal to switch between the computers, or you can just unplug one USB cable to get it to switch to the other one. It comes with a free companion software that you can download from iConnectivity.com that allows you to go in and change some of the routing inside of the device for the USB ports and for the outputs on the back. Now let's see it in action. I'm going to play a sound using the MIDI controller. It's going to be a strings patch, and on computer B, I'm going to switch it so it's one octave lower. That way you can tell exactly when the failover happens. Now let's move on to the more important question. Is this device worth buying? In short, I'd lean towards yes, but it really depends on the budget and resources of your program. Number one concern that comes up, do you need to buy two separate computers? Not necessarily. You really only need full redundancy for competitions and other performances. So that means you could use a personal computer or a staff member's computer for those specific days. It's not ideal and it's not a long-term solution, but it'll help in a pinch to help you move towards full redundancy. Next thought is ease of mind. Will this device solve any main stage problems that could come up during a performance? No, it won't. There's still other things that could happen, like a USB jack going out on your MIDI controller. Those inputs are notoriously fragile and will absolutely go out at the worst possible times. Good user practices are also important. This device won't save you if you leave your computers out in the sun and they overheat, or if you're turning them on and off after your warm-up and before your performance. Things like that aren't doing you any favors. If the $600 price tag sounds a little steep and is leaving you with a bit of sticker shock, then maybe you should hold off for a little while. In reality, this device won't make your setups invincible. And honestly, in the marching arts, you really won't even see the failover feature get used that often. With our performance times being so short, you really won't see that many issues come up in a 4 to 11 minute performance. The vast majority of things you'll see happen will come up during your initial setup time for your performance. And those can be easily solved by having a backup computer ready, or another USB cable or MIDI controller. Now, am I saying not to buy this device? No, because it's totally possible that this thing could save the day. And if you have the money in your budget, then go for it. Otherwise, stick to backup plans that won't break the bank. Something is better than no plans at all. That's it for this video. What type of backup plans do you have? Let us know in the comments down below. And if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe. And if this video is helpful, leave us a like. And we'll see you in the next one.